How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Who, he, he, ho, five, he, him, he, ha. All right, what did I get up to?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to a new episode of How Many, the only podcast on the internet that truly counts. I am your host, Jesse Jackson. Joining me today is Gary, Bob Jr., and Scott Matula. Scott, I understand we are going to go in the world of rock and roll.
Yes, we're going to talk about the greatest frontmen and women of rock and roll bands. Unlike last time, we're not going to do just American bands. We are doing rock and roll bands, period.
Point of clarification, like the Beach Boys, all five members sang lead, but you would tend to think Mike Love is the front man.
I wouldn't call Mike Love a front man only because, like you said, they all sang lead. I think your front man has to clearly be a front man, a center of attention.
Yeah, the Beach Boys are kind of like the Eagles. Like,
that's exactly what I was about to ask. Does that mean that neither the Beach Boys nor the Eagles are on this list?
No, I wouldn't put the Eagles on this list because, for the most part, I would say they're all equal.
It's got to be somebody who's literally the face of the band, right? The person you think
Mick Jagger.
Yeah.
Freddie Mercury.
Yeah. So, like, for example, the Beatles, since they have multiple frontmen, wouldn't count, right?
No frontmen.
Okay. What kind of sample size are we talking, Scott?
Okay. The original list I had was 96 people.
Okay.
And I've pared it down. I took out some people that I felt like, yeah, okay, they weren't really frontmen, just exactly what we talked about. So we're going with 65 here.
Because, Scott, isn't another component not just the person you think of, but somebody that actually gets the crowd involved, like, does antics on stage? You know, it's not just the person who sings. There's a whole performance, right?
Like, their shtick, yes.
So, Bob, you're basically saying that the frontman has to do the whole Radio Gaga thing.
Pretty much.
To get the crowd.
Ayo!
Ayo! Ayo! Ayo! Ayo!
Okay, so whenever we consider our number, are we also going to factor in any possible honorable mentions that you may have excluded from your 65?
I think we should, because I think that there are some that you guys might say, hey, wait, what about that I've taken off of there? I mean, there's certainly a couple that I left off the list because of its personal bias. Like, hey, I think that person's great. But is the group going to think that?
I think at the end, we should do a quick rundown of the people you took off the list.
I was just going to say, let's look at it like this. Like, we're going to base the number off the 65. And at the end, Scott will just give us a rapid fire for the other 30-ish.
Yeah, that sounds good.
All right. So, Jesse, what is your guess of the 65? And keep in mind, we could add honorable mentions that could add to that number.
I'm going to do 35.
Bob?
I will go 40.
Okay.
Gary?
42.
Boy, I'm tempted to go 43.
Just a big gap block you.
Yeah.
I'll do 38.
Okay.
And Scott, I know you've already seen the list, but if you were to guess how many we're going to count, what would your number be?
I really thought that you guys would hit like around 46, 47.
Okay.
Oh, okay. So you were taking
and
the over then.
And so I'm the high guy right now?
You are. Yeah.
Okay. Standing tall at 65 would be Lemmy.
From Motorhead. He definitely counts.
Hell yes,
he's almost the frontman for an entire genre.
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay, next on the list would be Sly Stone.
Yes, from Sly and the Family Stone.
Boy.
See, there's a little bit of age factor going on there. Like,
is
pretty iconic to me. I think I would count
Sly and the Family Stone.
I will count him because I just saw that Hulu documentary, Summer of Soul. He really did have that.
I mean,
dynamic.
He did a lot.
Yeah.
Not only that, not only did he star in Rocky, but he wrote it.
Stallone.
Scott Weiland.
Yes.
I'm going to say no.
Whoa.
It shocks you.
Stone Temple Pilots.
Yeah.
Oh.
Bob, I'm with you.
I mean, I like Stone Temple Pilots, and he was a good singer. He was the frontman of the band, but when I think of frontman from that era, he doesn't rank above guys like Vedder and some of these other guys.
Yeah, see, I'd put him above Vedder. The only reason that he's not higher is because he had such a bad heroin problem. So there were gaps in his career that would have could have been filled with good music if he wasn't such a junkie.
He went on to do Velvet Revolver. I would say yes to him. Stone Temple Pilots has so many great songs.
Yeah, I'm a big Scott Weiland fan. I love
it. And he was definitely the face of that band.
Jesse, you're the tiebreaker.
Could not name a Stone Temple Pilot song if I had to.
Really?
Yes, I am the Scott Matula of like movies
you
on this topic.
You would recognize him if you heard him.
Yeah, I will say yes.
Next one would be Frank Zappa.
No, yes. That one I would say no.
No.
See, I love Valley Girl, but...
Yeah, I'm not a Zappa fan.
Zappa was more of a virtuoso than a frontman.
I recognize that he is a huge influence and there are millions of people that love his work. I just don't think of him as a Mick Jagger type.
That's no, I'm out.
All right, Sebastian Bach, Skid Row.
Solinger or GTFO?
Yeah, I mean, Skid Row has a couple of decent songs, but yeah, I wouldn't call him a iconic frontman.
Hey, I'm not arguing. David Byrne.
Yes.
Ooh.
He had lots talking of heads. Hits, lots of yes. Schtick. He's the first guy you think of when you think of Talking Heads.
He is definitely like the first guy I think of when I think of giant suits.
You may ask yourself, why such a big suit? You may ask yourself, can this suit be taken in a little?
Yes. Burning down the house. Burning down the house. Absolutely.
I would count him. I would say yes.
I give him, yeah.
I'm going to be the dissenter here, but that's okay.
Ian Anderson.
Jethro Tull.
Jethro Tull.
Now, PD would demand we include him.
Bob, of course. Bob Marinin would demand.
Yes.
Marinin loved Jethro Tull.
Man, I am on the fence on this one. It's tough.
It is tough.
Can you be a frontman if you play the flute? He had a bit.
The flute and the leg up on the leg. He had the crazy face. He did a bunch of weird stuff.
I'll be honest. When I was a little kid, I thought that's who Jethro Tull was.
Yeah. I, you know what? I'm going to count.
I'm saying yes.
I mean, I like yes Aqualung.
That is their one.
Okay, Vince Neil.
Yes. That's a first ballot right there. The greatness of all the crew.
What's his name now? Vince Meal? Dr. Feedgood.
Yes to Vince Neil.
Dave Mustaine.
Megadeth.
That's a yes for me.
Megadeth.
Yeah, I would say yes too.
Well, now, Megadeth got like 10 good songs. Is it me or the real me?
Hello me.
Hello me. Meet the real me.
In my misfits way of life.
Hello me. Meet the real me.
In my misfits way of life.
See, I'm going to say no. I never felt like he was the face of the band to me. He was just always the singer.
He was the face of the band to me. Plus, he was a spinoff of Metallica. So the fact that he would leave Metallica to make his own band, I think cements him as the face.
That's kind of the point. In Metallica, he definitely blended in because he wasn't the face of the band. But then in going out on his own and starting Megadeth, I would say yes to that. I'm a big Megadeth fan. If you made me choose between Megadeth and Metallica, I'd probably would take Megadeth.
Jesse, can you name one Megadeth song?
Not for $1 million.
Who's buying? Come on.
I vote yes.
So, Bob, I think it's up to you.
Yeah, I'm going to say no.
Okay, we have three. We have three.
Trent Reznor.
Yes, Nine Inch Nails.
He's kind of a solo act, though. I mean, it's Nine Inch Nails. Who else is in the band?
That's the point. He is the face of the band. Like,
you can't be a solo artist and a frontman.
I don't know if Bruce Springsteen will be on this, but it's Bruce Springsteen in the E Street Band. It's Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. So, yes, he's the frontman.
If he's the only person you can think of when you think of that band, that is the epitome of being the frontman.
That's a good point.
Now, that said, I don't know if everybody voted for him. I vote yes.
I'm voting for him. I don't even like him, but I would vote for him. Mark Knopfler.
Dire Straits.
No, and I love Dire Straits, and I love Mark Knopfler, but he just is a guy that plays guitar and sings and does nothing else.
I will give you that argument.
He has no bits, no shtick.
I want to vote yes just because of the Princess Bride soundtrack he did. I mean, this guy is so talented.
He's awesome.
I'm going to say no. because I'm whipped by the headband.
But I do think you don't picture him as a front man.
It's funny because I hear everything you're saying and I agree with you, yeah. And I wouldn't include him, but they have this small list of songs that I really, really like.
Yeah.
And they got popular around like Money for Nothing and Sultans of Swing and things like that. But I know that to a Dire Straits fan, that's not really Dire Straits. I get why that is. And for that reason, I wouldn't call him a frontman.
Yeah.
I'm going to say no, just because when I think of Dire Straits, I think of that really bad Nintendo graphics animation in Money for Nothing more than I think of
him. That was an awesome movie.
We got to where install microwave oven.
That's the kitchen delivering.
We got to install microwave oven.
That's the kitchen delivering.
Carlos Santana.
Yes.
I'm with you there. I mean, he's the face of that band, definitely. Jerry Garcia.
Grateful Dead is a lot like the Eagles and some of these other bands, because you got him, you got Bob Weir, you got all these other guys that sing as well.
Boy, but he just was iconic.
But is he a front man?
Yeah.
He's definitely an icon, but I would picture him standing real still and singing a lot.
Sitting on a stool.
I like him better in skeleton form.
Bob Weir was probably more technically the front man of Grateful Dead most of the time than Jerry Garcia.
All right.
Fair enough.
Now, if you said Cherry Garcia, I would be
yes.
David Coverdale. Here I go again on my own.
Going down the only road I've ever known. From Whitesnake?
That's a yes for me.
Whitesnake, Deep Purple.
I would say yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
Sure.
Greg Allman.
And the Allman Brothers. Boy.
No.
That's a tough one.
It's tough by the frontman criteria. I'm a big fan.
He's the piano version of Mark Knopfler. He's great at what he does. He sits there and he sings, but he doesn't do anything else.
I remember from the documentary that he was uncomfortable being thrust into the front or the limelight there.
We're all uncomfortable being thrust into. So,
one of the things Gary brings up a couple of times, right, is our consistency. And sometimes we are damn inconsistent in these as we discuss this. But I do agree because, is he a well-known name? Is it a well-known person? Obviously, the Allman Brothers. I would agree. I would say not a front man or person. So,
and
I agree.
He didn't even sing their biggest hit.
Which one do you consider their biggest hit?
Ramblin' Man.
So that's a no. Susanna Hoffs. Just another manic Monday.
Wish it was Sunday. Ooh. You from the Bengals? That's, yeah.
Yeah.
Even though she didn't sing
make that other list.
She didn't sing all of the songs, but when you think of the Bengals, that's the first person you think of.
The first thing I think of is her. The previously discussed Brian Wilson. Let's see how consistent we are.
Before I was obsessed with Bruce Springsteen, I was obsessed with Brian Wilson. Brian Wilson is the leader of the Beach Boys.
He's the mastermind.
He is the mastermind, but he was not comfortable on stage. Right. Hell, his solo tours, he sits behind a piano. I would make the argument that Mike Love could be on the list because he is the one that does all the banter and stuff when you see the Beach Boys live. But no, as much as I love Brian, he's not a great frontman.
Whoever sang Kokomo should be the frontman because that's the only good song they have.
John Stamos.
John Stamos, yes.
Okay, Michael Hutchence. Devil inside, the devil inside.
Every single one of us, the devil inside. Yes, from NXS, he absolutely is the frontman.
He is almost like a textbook definition of a frontman.
Right.
Yeah.
I give you that one.
Yeah.
My only concern with that is just a little bit short lived, but he was definitely a front man.
He didn't hang around long enough.
This next one, I didn't necessarily agree with him being in the top 50, but I left him there, was Ian Gillan.
The Master, Deep Purple.
I've seen Deep Purple, who I consider to be the master.
Deep Purple, he sang with Black Sabbath as well.
Yeah. I would say no. Because Ritchie Blackmore drew a lot of the focus.
I would say no.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm a no on that, I guess.
He has to go back to his island.
All right, Joan Jett. Singing, I love rock and roll. Spend a long time in the jukebox, baby.
Yes, definitely.
Very
much so. I give Joan Jett a huge nod there.
Yeah. Similar to Dave Mustaine in that she started with one band and then spinned off on her own.
She was kind of the lead in the other band, too.
Yeah. I thought Lita Ford was more the lead.
No, not Lita Ford, Sherry Curry.
Lita Ford, Sherry Curry. I could see that argument being made, but that was sort of an ensemble thing. Like they were all big stars.
Okay, Billy Idol.
It doesn't really feel like Billy Idol is part of a band.
This
like,
is Bob's argument for the solo thing.
Yeah.
I'm with you.
He has the charisma. Now, I don't know. Is it the Billy Idol band? I don't know the band.
No, it's just Billy Idol.
Yeah.
Steve Stevens, that dude was a huge guitarist. He was like the Randy Rhodes of that era.
Like to me, if there isn't an actual name of a band that he's involved with, then he's to me a solo act.
He was Generation X.
Yeah, I was gonna say Generation X before Billy Idol.
But his heyday was as Billy Idol.
Okay. Peter Gabriel.
Boy, I mean, unless you're just counting his time with Genesis, like he was kind of a solo act too.
They were very theatrical.
I tend to think of him as a solo artist though.
Yeah, because I mean you also had Michael Rutherford.
Yeah, and Phil Collins.
Phil Collins.
I would say no.
I'm gonna say no.
All right. Belinda Carlisle.
Yes.
Go-Go's, yes. Same thing. When you mention the Go-Go's, you immediately think of Carla.
I agree.
Although Jane Wiedlin had
Harry looks
a solo
like he has something
too.
To say.
She definitely was the leader. I'm not going to say she wasn't the leader, but I thought the band was bigger than her. But then we start getting into the argument of, well, if the band isn't big, then it's just Billy Idol again or Ozzy Osbourne again. Yeah. And then does it count? So yeah, I'd count her.
Another thing to consider is, were they able to, after the success of their band, go on and have their own solo career? And she kind of did that.
I would say yes to Belinda Carlisle.
I won't say no to the Go-Go.
Okay, Bob Marley.
Yes.
The Wailers, yes.
Yeah, almost like Jesse said, if your band is your name and the, that's almost default.
Yeah, he was the center of the band. He was the guy. But, you know, that band was made up of a lot of really talented guys that went off and had successful solo careers on their own.
Right.
Yep.
You know? Okay, so Bob Marley's a yay. All right. Joey Ramone.
Hey, oh, let's go. Hey, oh, let's go.
Yeah.
I call him a frontman.
Yeah, I think so.
You know, even though they all looked alike and dressed alike, Joey was the one who was the spokesperson. He was the one who talked.
He had that iconic.
Yeah, I agree. You
know. Ann Wilson.
No, her and the sisters share so much of the focus.
Ann and Nancy.
Especially in the
80s. I think of more as a duo.
Yeah, in the 80s, they purposely made all the attention go towards Nancy than Ann. It was definitely a shared thing.
Phil Collins.
Yes.
No.
What was his band?
Yeah, I'm going to say
Genesis.
No, we just did that. There were three other guys in Genesis.
Phil Collins as a solo artist? Absolutely. I just don't see
him. Behind the piano. He's Snoopy.
I think his run with Genesis was long enough and I guess successful enough for him to be considered the front man of Genesis, in my opinion.
The front man of Genesis. That's
you can't,
the thing.
Can you be a front man if you're the drummer?
Say no on Phil Collins?
I guess. Begrudgingly.
It's tough, but given our criteria, no.
Rod Stewart.
Yeah. What is it? The Faces? Is that the
band?
The Faces,
he was in Faces.
I mean, he really knew how to pump up a crowd.
He left them drained, but I just don't know.
I wasn't expecting that from you, Jesse.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's the fact that it came from you is what makes it so shocking. I expect that from Bob, not from you.
I just think him more as a solo artist.
I feel the same way. I mean, I know he was the front man of Faces, but that's I think of him more solo.
Okay, Sammy Hagar.
Yes.
Yeah.
And he was definitely the front man for Van Halen when he was in Van Halen. And then he has his own bands that he's been in even since Van Halen.
I'm glad you clarified that because I honestly wasn't sure if we would be willing to consider the same band having two frontmen, even though they were because it was different eras.
I would, although he also was in Montrose and other bands.
Yeah, his time with Van Halen is enough to have him be considered a non-solo frontman.
Having seen Van Hagar, he did do a lot of frontman shtick.
Yeah. It's very similar to Black Sabbath when you consider the Ozzy era and the Dio era.
Yes.
I would consider both of them frontmen.
Yeah, that's a really good comparison.
Okay, Neil Young.
Well, no. I know that is one of your favorites.
Yes, it is.
But
see Mark Knopfler.
Yeah.
Right. Same situation.
I got you, because he does come across as more as a solo.
Well, not even that, but even when he's in Crazy Horse, I mean, he's just hunched over going to town on his guitar. He's not really
pumping anybody up.
He's not flamboyant.
Yeah, I agree.
Janis Joplin.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a short career.
Because yeah, Big Brother in the Holding Company, that's the band. Yeah.
I'd say yes.
I'd say yes, too. She is an icon. I mean,
yeah,
and
small
yes.
amount of work, but yes.
She's the one that people were coming to see. Iggy Pop.
Now I wanna be your dog.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I would agree.
Dude is greatness.
Yeah.
Quintessential frontman.
Lane Staley.
Yeah, they come to snuff the rooster.
Yes, Alice in Chains.
Yes, for me, yeah.
Yeah, I would vote him over Weiland on the heroin junkie frontman.
I like Weiland more, but they're both awesome.
Okay, Ronnie Van Zant.
I'm as free as bird now.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm there with you. Anthony Kiedis.
I have to say yes.
I think you kind of have to, man. Yeah.
He's a more modern version of Iggy Pop.
He's kind of copy-pasted. Yeah.
He is a hell of a sideshow, but it's still all about Kiedis.
All right, Rob Halford.
Breaking the law, breaking the law. Breaking the law, breaking the law.
Yes. Judas Priest, yes.
That was a that was
if they had just listened to the lyrics to Living After Midnight, they would have known before it ever came out.
Debbie Harry.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's the first thing you think of when you think of
with
Blondie.
Blondie. Absolutely. Yeah,
with Blondie, that's what you think of. Okay. As the before mentioned, Ronnie James Dio.
Yes.
Yep.
This one, I'm not sure how to pronounce his name. It's,
it's the it's the artist formerly known as Prince.
Yeah. Yeah, so Prince.
That's a big hell yes.
This is what it sounds like when the doves cry.
Yes.
Yeah.
He had a long enough run with the Revolution for him to be considered a frontman of a band before he went solo and became a symbol.
Yeah, I
agree.
This one I think is controversial, as I think other members would argue. Sting.
Roxanne, you don't have to wear that dress tonight.
It's the Police.
Yeah, I think the Police.
But you also think the Police when you say Stu Copeland.
Yeah, and I don't know that Sting did a whole lot of frontman shtick either. He just kind of played the bass and sang.
When it came to the Police music videos, it felt like he was the
most focused on.
He was definitely the, like you say, the target of the lens, yeah.
So I would say yes.
Junior, that's a really good point. When that one person becomes the focus, that's the face.
It's kind of the opposite of what happened to Hart, because the singer wasn't the person that the camera was always focused on.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. All right. I'll go with Sting.
Yeah.
Okay. Tom Petty.
Baby, break down. Go ahead, give it to me.
Yes.
Yes.
It follows the criteria of somebody's name and so and so.
Yeah.
There you go.
The only exception to that is going to be Jay Giles. He is not.
Steve Perry.
Don't stop believing.
Yes.
Yeah.
No.
I'm a yes.
I'm a huge yes.
Yeah, I'm a big yes.
A lot going on in Journey. Neil Sean's up there. The voice is iconic, but
outside of Separate Ways, when you think of the Journey music videos, they're always concert videos, and it's always focused on him all sweaty in front of a crowd of like 60,000 people singing.
I saw them twice. And he was always the guy. I mean, yeah, Neil Sean would have his big guitar solo and Steve Smith would have his big drum solo. But Steve Perry was the guy that was always running across the stage, whipping people up and this side. Okay, now this side.
Yeah, plus he went on and had a solo career after. And once he left Journey was never the same.
Oh, you're out on the Filipino guy?
All he was doing was playing old Journey songs.
Honestly, I think that guy's name is Arnell.
Arnell. His name is actually Arnell.
Yes, it is Arnell. Okay, Bruce Dickinson.
Yes.
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 Iron Maiden.
Yes, Iron Maiden. What do you know about Iron Maiden, Jesse?
They're a heavy metal band.
Can you name one Iron Maiden song?
Now, hold on before you answer. The answer was in the questions episode that we just did.
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember.
Can I play with madness? Can I play with madness?
Jesse, you had to have heard The Trooper, right? You take my life, but I'll take your stew.
You fire your musket, but I'll run you through.
You take my life, but I'll take your stew.
You fire your musket, but I'll run you through.
I'm sure on many of these, when I heard them. Although,
that may not be their biggest hit. Their biggest hit may be, run to the hills.
Yeah.
Run for your life. Run to the hills. Run for your life.
Okay, John Bon Jovi.
Yes.
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 Reluctantly, yes.
The Touchdown Brothers definitely vote for Bon Jovi.
Oh, living on the grass.
They don't make music like that anymore, do they?
No, they don't. There it is for the fourth time this hour. Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi.
Bob, here's a dad joke for you. I was watching an episode of Modern Family earlier, and Phil was learning to play the banjo. Claire called him Bon Jovi.
Let's see how this one goes. John Fogerty.
My immediate thought is yes, but is he like Mark Knopfler? That's he is there straight.
Yeah, he definitely is.
I've watched him solo, and
I've got to stay consistent because Gary's always on me about flip flopping.
Yeah,
I already set my precedent, so I have to say no to Fogerty.
Wow,
I can't recall seeing old performances of Creedence to see. Okay, did he stand out?
No, he's just in a lumberjack outfit.
Yeah, he's not an energetic stage presence. He's very similar to Neil Young in that way.
Yeah, you know what? I think to stay consistent, I mean, my immediate thought is, yes, he is CCR, but once again, not a great frontman.
Brian Johnson.
Yes.
Hold on.
He's not the greatest frontman that they've had, but he still would count.
I don't think you can count him because so much focus and imagery is based around Angus.
Angus?
The anus?
Only when he's doing his cakewalk across the stage.
But Angus is like the mascot of the band. He's on all the album covers.
I would vote more easily for Bon Scott before I would vote for Brian Johnson, but I would still count him.
I've never seen Bon Scott as the front man in concert, but when his name comes up, I will vote for him. But I have seen AC/DC in concert, and I will vote for Brian Johnson.
I will too.
Okay. David Lee Roth.
Oh, yes. He is the epitome.
He's like top five.
If you were making a front man on a computer, you'd end up with David Lee Roth.
I mean, he checked every box on the front man checklist.
Yes.
If for nothing else, for the isolated vocals of...
Running with the devil.
Here you go, Gary. Chris Cornell.
Yes.
Yeah.
I would vote for him too.
Yeah, I agree.
Alice Cooper.
Yes. Again, it's like Jethro Tull. Everybody thought he was the name, and then when he went solo,
he kept the name though. That's what makes me feel like he is a solo act.
No, even though he wasn't really. Band. It was Alice Cooper was the band before he started going by that.
Yeah, he was famous as the front man for Alice Cooper before he became Alice Cooper.
Okay, right, yeah, I would vote yes.
This will be a discussion point. Stevie Nicks.
No, she's greatness.
It's kind of like the Eagles, man.
Very, very shared. Just,
there's too many.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
There's a lot of flavor to that suit. Bruce Springsteen.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Yes.
Wait, who?
So obviously, I'm going to vote yes. He is the lead of the band, right? And he does
a lot of frontman things too.
I mean, even at an advanced age, he's a very high energy guy.
Yes,
right. It feels like the camera was more focused on Clarence Clemens and the Sopranos guy at all times.
Silvio, yes.
Okay, Eddie Vedder,
yes,
yes.
Eddie. I say yes.
I'll say this for a frontman. This is a guy who his entire career, he has been just like what you were making fun of Vince Neil earlier for not singing. He gets up there and he just hums to what would be the words to a song that you know the words to, but he never actually says them.
He's turned into the Adam Sandler version of himself.
He is. He just gets up there and goes,
It's Eddie Vedder.
Oh my gosh. All right, okay. Dave Grohl.
Yes.
Dave Grohl.
Yeah.
Bon Scott.
Yes.
Yeah. I give Bon
I'm
going
to say the same thing as I did about Brian Johnson, man. I still think Angus is too much of a focal point.
Not back in the day, man. Not when Bon Scott.
No, man. That camera was focused all over Bon Scott in those old concert videos.
Yeah, you watch those.
Those midnight special videos.
We know that you focus on the Angus a lot.
The Angus?
The anus?
It wasn't until Highway to Hell that they started to feature Angus.
No, look, he was on the cover of High Voltage. He was on the cover of TNT. Right.
Well,
they were all on the cover of High Voltage.
There were some that they were all on the cover of, but he was also.
So Bob has reduced us down to who's on the cover of the album.
I'm still going to give Bon Scott the nod. You know, I've seen videos of him up there. He's up there with his bulging pants or wearing a dress or
and his
wearing
British
a blonde wig with pigtails and all that kind of stuff. And
singing Big Balls.
So
I've got big balls. Oh, you've got big balls.
You sound like yours haven't dropped yet.
I've got big balls. Oh, you've got big balls.
Kurt Cobain. Hey, wait, I
gotta live away. Yes.
Yeah.
Another short career, but he was the face of Nirvana. He was the face of grunge.
If you were the face of the biggest band on the planet, even for a year, you're a frontman.
Yeah.
He was the face of a whole musical movement.
He just scoliosed.
That face got blown off, but he was still the face of that band.
I just think of him on scoliosis up, sitting there hunched over. He wasn't really doing anything. He was just kind of.
If you watch the Smells Like Teen Spirit video, he's jumping all over the place. He's definitely not sedentary.
But no.
Yes. Yeah. Bono, absolutely. Yeah.
Yes.
And this one I have to say yes because I always thought he was the guy. Roger Daltrey.
We don't get fooled again.
When I was young, absolutely. I thought he was the one that wrote everything. I thought he was the Who, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah.
I don't know. Pete Townsend breaking the guitar all over the stage.
I would go with Daltrey.
I would too, but it's more shared. It's not a no-brainer.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Axl Rose. Welcome to the jungle.
We got fun and games. Yes. I mean, Slash got parts of the attention too, but Axl was definitely the front man.
Yeah, if you watch them in concert, there will leave no doubt what kind of a front man he is.
Right.
That dude never stopped. That guy was insanely high energy.
And there were times he just never showed up on stage.
That's true.
Okay, this one has the Journey paradox. Steven Tyler. Dream on, dream on, dream on,
dream the top dream come true. I'm a big yes for that.
Yeah, that's a yes.
I mean, yeah, Aerosmith. Yeah.
Joe Perry was a big guy. But I'd give it to Steven Tyler. Yeah.
Jimi Hendrix.
Yes.
Yeah. And Who the now? Experience.
Yeah.
Oh, Jimi Hendrix? Yeah.
Ozzy Osbourne. Can you help me?
Not you from my brain. Yes.
I'd give it to him for his work with Dio, but
I should probably just click all these last four. Jim Morrison, first ballot, right? Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to
set the night on fire. Yep. Yes, even though Jesse hates them.
I'm not a Doors fan, but yes.
Cumby will be so happy.
I hate them too, but Jim Morrison was a guy. Mick Jagger. Pleased to meet you. Hope you guessed my name.
Yes.
Definitely top five.
Robert Plant.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Why did you say it
Robert
like that?
Robert Plant over because, Mick Jagger?
Because I think that to a certain extent, again, it's the Journey paradox. You know, guitarist was also just as important
as
Jimmy
Page
was
a big,
you know,
player.
Oh, there's no doubt.
So who do you think's number one?
Well, I would have bet Jagger.
Yeah, I would have thought
what
Jagger,
did we
too.
Not do? Hold on a second. What have we?
Freddie Mercury.
We
That's
yeah, Freddie
yeah,
Mercury.
Freddie Mercury.
Yeah. Sing it.
And he probably really is number one.
Yeah, I think so.
Him, Jagger, and DLR are probably.
Is it ironic that the greatest front man of all time was actually kind of a rear man?
You want me to go through the other 30 really fast?
Yes,
quick hit.
It is time. It's time for the lighting round. And then the lighting rounds are
up. Joe Elliott.
From Def Leppard.
Nah.
That's pretty much frontman, dude.
Now, I don't think he is a household name. Like, if you walk to somebody up on the street and ask who the lead singer of Def Leppard was, you probably wouldn't get a lot of correct answers.
Other than being Kim Cattrall in drag, he's pretty nondescript.
20 years ago, I think you would.
Scott, you did what Junior said 20 years ago, you'd get a whole lot of right answers. And he absolutely, for Def Leppard, was the front man of that band.
Yeah, he checked all the front man boxes.
Okay. Simon Le Bon.
Yes, I would say yes to him. He was definitely the face of Duran Duran.
Yeah, I agree.
Michael Stipe.
R.E.M., right?
I think you have to.
Robin Zander.
Cheap Trick. I think Rick Nielsen. It's almost like the Angus thing. So much focus on him, the bit and everything.
Lou Gramm.
Foreigner.
Yeah, that's...
He was the singer.
He definitely was the singer. I couldn't speak to how much of a frontman he is because as much of a fan as I was a Foreigner back in the 80s, I couldn't tell you what any of them looked like during a concert or whatever.
Right.
When I think of Foreigner videos, I think of the really slow ballads, and he's not really doing much.
Rob Zombie.
Yes. During his White Zombie era, I would say
Zombie era.
Yeah.
He was definitely the face of White Zombie.
I would say yes to that.
Joe Strummer. Clash.
No, because Mick Jones, that was kind of a duo also.
Okay, Robert Smith.
Yes, yeah. From The Cure. Yeah, I would say yes.
I'd rather put in Edward Scissorhands.
I mean, he had that very...
He is very Edward Scissorhands looking.
Yeah, he was.
When they made that movie, they were basing it on his look.
Yeah, we're going to let you butcher this movie just like he butchered being a front man.
Okay, Lou Reed.
Yeah.
Just Lou Reed, right?
Velvet Underground.
That's true. Yeah. Velvet Underground. I forgot about that.
I would have voted,
Jeff Lynne.
ELO.
Yes. ELO, yes. In fact, that should have made the list. I'm a big ELO fan. And
I love ELO.
And Jeff Lynne.
And Jeff Lynne sings all the songs and writes all the songs, but he's just nondescript. He doesn't do much performance-wise.
Yeah, he doesn't have a real strong stage presence to me.
Okay.
Zach De La Rocha.
Oh,
Rage Against the Machine. That's a big yes.
I thought Tom Morello is the guy.
Well, he's the guitarist, but Zach is the singer.
Yeah, Zach
he's out front. But Jesse, you make a good point. That's kind of a two-headed thing.
It's not, though. I mean, everybody knows who De La Rocha is. Absolutely count him.
I would count him, too.
Yeah, I'll count him.
Klaus Meine.
Scorpions.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, Bret Michaels.
Yes. Yeah. Boy, that should have been on the... That's on the list. That's a big time frontman.
You have to look too. The 80s hair bands are like quintessential frontmen. It's a bunch of guys that look like Scott up there kicking and screaming. And
I would put him higher than Joe Elliott.
Okay, Mark Bolan.
T-Rex.
Yeah. Only had one song.
Basically, he and Bowie kind of started glam rock.
Yeah, I'm with you, Scott. You can't be that much of a stage presence when you get on stage, do bang a gong, and then just quietly walk off stage.
David Johansen.
Now, Buster Poindexter.
Yeah, and now if you said Buster Poindexter.
I'm a big fan of his daughter's work, Scarlet.
Elvis Costello.
Yeah, Elvis Costello and The Attraction, yes.
Morrissey.
No, he is definitely the face
of the Smiths, but I wouldn't count him.
This one I would like to have been in the top 65, Paul Westerberg.
Ooh, Replacements. Yeah, I would count him.
Eric Burdon.
Yes, and The Animals.
I would say yes to him.
And last but not least, Paul Rogers.
Bad Company. Pretty generic.
Yeah, generic.
Yeah.
He tours around doing a lot of the Bad Company stuff now just as himself. That kind of makes me wonder.
Speaking of Paul's. We did not mention Paul Stanley.
Yeah, that's a good
point. Because that's shared. Him and Gene Simmons.
Yeah, it's very shared.
Now, I do have a couple that I didn't hear get called. How about Buddy Holly and the Crickets?
He definitely an icon of rock and roll. He certainly was the lead. I don't know how much he did to hype up the crowd and such.
Yeah, because you could do the same thing with Elvis. It's Elvis and the Heartbreakers and
Bill Haley and the Comets.
Bill Haley and the Comets.
How about Huey Lewis and the News?
Ooh. Well, that's
actually a pretty good one.
I think that actually
is.
Yeah,
that one I would do.
Yeah, I would vote for him.
I've got one. What about Geddy Lee?
From Rush?
Oh, I'm a yes for that.
Yeah, I would say yes. Yeah, he's definitely a frontman.
He sang all their songs. He was out front on the stage.
And here's one that is probably shared, but when I think of the theatrical side of this band, I think of him. How about Dennis DeYoung?
Boy, it's really shared, man. It's Tommy Shaw, James Young, those guys all split songs.
But when it comes to the video era of Styx, he was the guy. He was in the suit. He was Kilroy.
I'm Kilroy! 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 Kilroy!
Definitely wanted all the attention, for sure.
I thought Tommy Shaw was the guy.
And the fact that you're having this discussion is exactly why he's probably not.
Now, a guy that just died recently, what about Chester Bennington?
Linkin Park?
A little bit split, but I could see that.
I didn't even know his name.
We definitely discussed him during
one of the deaths episodes. Hey, what about the Limp Bizkit guy or
Fred Durst? Fred Durst, yes. Creed guy, no.
You said we couldn't count Jay Giles, but could we count Peter Wolf?
You absolutely could count Peter Wolf.
Could count Peter Wolf.
You should count Peter Wolf. Lights Out?
Uh-huh. Blast, blast, blast.
Lights Out?
Uh-huh. Blast, blast, blast.
What do you think about Dee Snider?
Yes.
Ooh, Twisted Sister? Yes. Yeah.
Man, wait, did Jesse just say Twisted Sister?
Yes.
Right? Out of all the stuff you don't know, you know Twisted Sister?
The video.
There's only two people you think of when you think of Twisted Sister, Dee Snider and Niedermeyer.
What do you want to do with your life?
I want to rock.
Twisted Sister. All right, Mr. Sister. I want you to tell me, what do you want to do with your life?
I want to rock.
What about Johnny Rotten?
Yeah, that's a really good one, although Sid Vicious drew a lot of focus.
But why,
yeah,
Johnny Rotten, you look like somebody just walked over your grave.
Why, Johnny Ringo, you look like somebody just walked over your grave.
Because also, you also had Public Image Limited, too.
All right, I think we've racked up about as many honorable mentions as possible.
100.
Yeah, what is our count looking like, Scott?
Of the original 65, we counted 50.
I knew I should have taken the over.
Boy, I went way under.
We added on 16 names.
So that puts us at 66 of the 100.
Yeah,
so who
good
won?
Stuff.
Gary did, I think.
Gary did. Very good topic, Scott. That was a lot of fun.
Good stuff.
Please give back to us and tell us who we forgot. Tell us that you think Bruce Springsteen is not a great front man and get me all raged up. You can find me on Set Lessing Bruce to tell me why he sucks. If someone wants to reach you, Bob, how can they?
At Lukewarm Tallboy on Twitter and Instagram.
Scott?
At Scott_Matula.
Gary?
At @travel_cowboy.
And I am at Jesse Jackson DFW Jr. If they want to give us feedback, how can they reach you and the show?
At Metzkin_Jr. on Twitter. You can reach the show at How Many Podcast also on Twitter. You can reach out to us through our YouTube page. We also have a Facebook page. You can go to howmanypodcast.com and listen to all of our older episodes. Lots of different ways to get a hold of us. Give us feedback. Let us know what front men or front women we missed on our list. I know we probably could have added another 50.
Well, very nice. And a shout out to David Proctor, who sent us a nice email. So, thank you, David.
And yes, our email inbox is always open to feedback.
We've had so many exchanges with him over the years. We might be considered proctorologists.
And tune in and watch Leverage Redemption, because my niece is going to be on there. That is on the IMDb TV now.
We found other people heard about us, so we recruited them.
I think I've deduced that you were a group of thieves to help people. Let me be your inside man.
Now we have 12 active teams.
Somebody's got to run it.
What about you?
No, I'm retired.
I want to take on the bad guys. These bad guys are worse than ever. Don't let me be
misunderstood. Thank you, listeners. Thank you, guys. We will talk to you soon.
I got the high score because I'm the